Hey, what's up, turtles? Krik here with Black Owl Outdoors. Welcome to the first shop video in my cramped working quarters. Today, I want to show you how I sew my leather projects together using the saddle stitch. Here's just a quick example to show you the stitch I'm talking about. This is white thread I have on the sheath I made. And you can tell there's a consistency to the stitch. You don't have the stitch darting in different directions as you follow it up its line. I'm going to explain all that in this video. Here are the tools I'm going to use today to accomplish a full stitch. Two needles here because the saddle stitch is a two needle type stitch with a single thread. And like I said, I will explain more of this as the video progresses. I'm going to use a lighter to end the stitch to burn it. Here's just my sample workpiece for today's video. Scissors to cut the thread when we're finished, and then a small pair of grooveless pliers to help pull the needle through the hole should we need it. I have my workpiece clamped in the stitching pony. The steps that got me to where I am right now, which is ready to stitch, is I've established my stitching line a consistent distance from the edge of the workpiece. I've marked my holes and then I punched the holes. Now I used a rotary punch today to keep this hole bigger, because what I'm after and I want to show you is a slant you can get with this stitch as it sits. So to start our stitch, what we're going to do is back stitch. You can count 1, 2, 3. You can go 4 if you want. Today's purpose, I'm just going to go 2. What I'm going to do is pull one needle through that and then even the sides out. Like I said, the saddle stitch is a two needle stitch, and essentially what we're doing is creating a chain of figure eights. So I just took the front needle, passed it through the whole way to the back. Now I'm passing the back needle the whole way to the front, pulling that tight, and our first link is created. I'm going to repeat that process, front needle pulled through to the back. Take the back needle and pass that through to the front, pull that tight, and there's our figure eight. I'm going to repeat this process, stitching towards the hole we started. And that'll complete our back stitch. Sometimes the needle can be stubborn just because of the extra thread in the hole. You just have to always make sure that the needle never passes through any thread. This is what's known as a back stitch, because the direction I want to stitch is this way. So what I'm doing is just securing the starting of this stitch. And it's doubled over in the stitch bed right there. So what I'm trying to do is make it as clean as I can and just make sure when I go slow and I'm pulling that last one through that I want to pay attention to where it's laying and how it looks in the stitching bed. And what I want to do, because this one's a little goofy, I'm just going to pass the needle through there just so it'll lay a little bit cleaner. All right, now's our back stitch. So that slant I was talking about, the reason why it's going to happen for us today is because this hole is big enough to actually create a slant. If you make really tiny holes in the leather, you're not going to be able to give the thread priority and get it to sit at a slant. So for how I get that slant and achieve it, if that's what I'm going for in the stitch, I pass, this is the front of my workpiece, pass it through there first. I leave a loop. I want to make sure this loop is important, because what we're doing is basically the first step in a box knot or a reef knot. I'm going to take my back needle, pass it through then. So you can see the thread that I passed from the front, and then the needle's going on this side of the hole. So what I'm going to do is then wrap this around the needle and then pull it through. And essentially that's putting the needle through that loop I created. And I pull that through when I go slow. You can sort of see how these are tightening on each other, and it almost looks, like I said, the first step in a box knot. And like I said, what that's doing is it's giving the thread priority in the hole. I'm just going to keep continuing this and move my way down to the stitching bed, and I'll show you how to finish the stitch. And there's the last one. We're ready to do our back stitch. Now if you pay attention to where these stitches are sitting in this hole, look where the end of the needle is. It's sitting in the bottom of this hole, traveling then to the top corner of this hole, and that's being repeated. Bottom, top, bottom, top, bottom, top. That gives you a really nice, clean looking, slanted stitch. Let's finish the stitching now, and with a back stitch, the same sort of thing we did at the beginning. Because these last two holes I'm designating as my back stitch, or stitches if you will, three holes, I don't give priority and do the slant in this because I use thicker thread. I just haven't messed with it. It's just really going to clog up the hole, if you will. And every time you go through, you have to make sure this needle is not passing through any of your thread. You do not want to do that. It's going to compromise the strength of your thread. As you can see, I went through there as I'm trying to talk and do this. I'm going to pull that out. What you see is what you get here at Black Owl. I could have edited that out and show you I don't make mistakes, but guess what? That's not the truth. The fact is, if you catch a mistake, you take it out. So sometimes what I'll do, because in traditional stitching, people will use an awl as they're stitching. I don't do that because it's a lot harder on the hands, and I try to just use holes. I don't think there's one method of creating holes, one better than the other in my experience. But sometimes what I'll do is come from the front and kind of create the hole using my needle. So when I pass through from the back, it's already been there, and I'm really not compromising going through any thread. So I pass that through there. Pull out the pliers. Okay, that's one. And now to finish this, because we only left ourselves two stitching to finish, this is the front of my workpiece. So now this needle is going to finish this stitch. So what I'm going to do is just pass this then through to the back side. Pull that through. And there we go. I'm going to take this out and flip it around. All right. So this is the back side of my workpiece. You can see these scars in here. Obviously, if I'm making something, I wouldn't use this piece of leather. That's why I'm using it for today's video as an example. So this is the back side, our back side of our project. So what I want to do is just trim the thread as close as I can pretty much to that hole. Now this can be accomplished with scissors, and I'm trying to show you these videos without super specific tools. But there are specific tools for, they're called thread cutters, that you can get real close in there and really control what you're doing. But scissors, if you're careful, you can get pretty decent results. So now we have snipped our thread. I'm going to take this out of the stitching pony, pull out that lighter. And we have our little ends right here is where we ended it. So because this is a wax synthetic thread, I can melt the ends of this. If you're going to be using linen or cotton, obviously that stuff's not going to melt. And what I'll do is just kind of touch the lighter there. Get those, I can tell they're accepting some heat, and they'll mushroom down. And I kind of smash them with my finger. And then sometimes I'll actually take an awl or something. And then just try to push that in the stitch hole just a little bit more. And that's all there is to it. I want to show you why this saddle stitch is used in utility projects. So I'm going to compromise a stitch by cutting it out, just severing that. You know, that could happen in the field over time. All right, that stitch completely gone now. But the beauty of this saddle stitch is essentially you having two lengths of thread running the entire workpiece independent of each other. So what I can do now is turn this over. I'm basically just gonna pull this one row out. So you can see right here, this is where the cut took place in that little stitch we started with, but there is still a length of thread running the length of the workpiece, keeping this tight together. And that's why the saddle stitch is used and why I use it all the time. So there it was, our first attempt at filming indoors. Let us know if you like it, if you want to see more. If you do want to see more, the easiest way is to just click the thumbs up button that lets us know you like what we're doing, and we will continue the shop videos. Have a couple leather related videos for you to check out as well. Until the next video, this is Krik with Black Owl Outdoors. Later, turtles.